October is exploding with news in the VR field, including the leaks of the Oculus Quest facial tracking, new controllers with cameras, rumors about a standalone VR headset from Valve, and of course a crazy amount of new game releases. Finally, we've got something interesting to talk about, and today we will discuss the new VR arrivals and the upcoming games which will be released this month and later this year. So buckle up, we've got a lot to cover, and if you're ready, let's go! First, let's quickly cover the games that have just gotten released. October has just begun and we've already got something exciting to play. Jurassic World Aftermath Part 2 is out if you've been playing hide and seek with dinosaurs, and this time you'll be hiding not just from the raptors, but from the giant T-Rex himself. The good news is that even if you haven't completed the first part yet, you can start the game immediately from the second part and jump straight into the action. This is a great plus, even though going through the first part is highly recommended to get the full enjoyment of the game. A brand new course called Quixote Valley has just arrived on Walkabout Minigolf, and this course features many firsts for the game, including windmills and a brand new wind mechanic that will alter your ball's trajectory in some areas, making it even more challenging to play, both to newbies and to experienced golfers. You don't need to buy this update. If you already have Walkabout Minigolf installed, you will find the new course right there, so jump right in it if you're ready for the challenge. All of you board game lovers will be happy for this one, because a brand new multiplayer VR board game collection game called Never Bored has just been released. It's filled with a growing list of fun board games for 2, 3 or 4 players. You can download the game right now and spend some quality time with your friends eating pizza and playing your favorite board games. Not exactly a game everyone will be able to play, but still worth mentioning, a location-based VR experience, Man in Black, is coming to Dreamscape LA. The trailer is being kind of cryptic regarding what the game entails, but hey, if you're ever in LA, stop by Dreamscape LA to check it out. Now, October the 7th is going to be a very busy day for VR, because a whole 4 games are coming out that day. Let's check them out. A long-anticipated game, Song in the Smoke, is finally coming to Oculus Quest, Rift, and PlayStation VR. Song in the Smoke is part survival adventure and part mysterious narrative, where you'll be able to hunt with bows and axes, forage for resources, and craft new items whilst exploring this beautiful prehistoric world and uncovering its secrets. Grab this beautifully mysterious game on October the 7th. On this day, we will also get an insanely fun game called Loco Dojo Unleashed, which is a collection of 16 hilarious and challenging party games that you will play either alone or with your friends. Unlock all the games and play by riding on piggies, making cactus kebabs, and having all sorts of fun with this strangely food and animal-centered game. I'm really looking forward to this one. October the 7th is the date. And yet another game coming on October the 7th is Wrath the Oblivion Afterlife. This game is going to be spooky as heck. This survival horror game is coming right in time for the spooky month, and if you're a horror fan, you're in for a treat. While we already have it on Steam and Quest systems, in just a week this game will become available for PlayStation VR. And finally, the fourth game coming October the 7th is Shadowgate VR, The Mines of Mythrock. And what we know about this title is that it is a fantasy adventure game exclusive to Oculus Quest. Shadowgate existed on other gaming platforms as well, dating back to the days of Macintosh PCs, and now it's making its debut in VR, and we're so excited about it. You'll wield magic, ride minecarts, and explore ancient dwarven mines, so keep an eye on that one. Lone Echo 2, a long-delayed sequel to a mega-popular PC VR game, Lone Echo, is finally upon us. This month, on October 12th, make sure to grab this gorgeous story-driven sci-fi puzzle title. And if you haven't played the original yet, you still have the time to finish it before this title drops. That way you'll make the most out of gaming. Coming to Oculus Rift. If you have played the free demo of the Eye of the Temple, then you know that this is a unique room-scale-based platformer where you don't have to teleport or use smooth locomotion, but every step you take in this game, you take in the real life. This Indiana Jones-style title has been a fan favorite for years, and I can't wait for the full version to get released with even more challenges and room-scale adventures. Look out for it on October 14th. What horror fans haven't played the Resident Evil series? It's arguably the most recognizable zombie shooter franchise, and I can hardly believe that it is finally coming to VR, more so in a standalone VR like Oculus Quest 2. You will need roughly 12 gigs of space on your headset to play it, and it is well worth remembering that it is a Quest 2 exclusive game. Are you curious how your adventures with Leon will translate into VR? I sure am! Mark October 21st as the Resident Evil 4 Day. And Unplugged is finally getting its full release. After releasing a short early release demo, Unplugged has won hearts of many music maniacs because now you get to relive your dream of being a rock star in this Guitar Hero type game with dozens of hit rock songs to play. I tried it and was utterly impressed by the quality of the hand tracking, and I even tried to play it with the real guitar in my hands, 3 weeks until the release of this epic title. Do Not Open is a love letter to all horror game fans out there who will appreciate the gift of this scary VR title coming to PlayStation VR on Halloween, October 31st. Face tons of scary puzzles as you try to escape this creepy house, and heads up, puzzles, riddles, and events are meant to change with each subsequent playthrough, keeping the game fresh and increasing its replayability. Are you looking forward to this one? And finally, a few games that will arrive by the end of 2021.
I can hardly believe it, but this year Medal of Honor is getting its standalone Oculus Quest 2 release, and it's going to make your Quest 2 sweat as it will take over 40 gigabytes of free space on your headset. Yes, it's an insanely huge game, the largest title to have ever been released on a standalone console, coming later this year. Another Quest 2 exclusive of the year! Are you excited about it? The release date is yet unknown, but perhaps we will hear more about it during the Facebook Connect event on October 28th. While we originally expected this game to arrive in the third quarter of 2021, Wanderer is being delayed, even though we still hope this beautiful title will arrive this year. Wanderer is a VR story-driven game where you will get to travel through time and be present at the most exciting events in history, like stepping on the surface of the moon and rocking with a band in front of thousands of people and so many more. This is one of the most exciting upcoming games for me personally, and I really hope we will get to play it later this year. A highly anticipated title with an uncertain date of release that we hope to be this year is After the Fall, coming from the creators of Arizona Sunshine, Vertigo Games. Venture out into the remains of post-apocalyptic LA, fight hordes of monsters in the ice-covered ruins of the long-lost city. It features an intense co-op gameplay at its core that pits up to 4 players against a post-apocalyptic VR world filled with ferocious undead, mutated and twisted creatures, coming to all major headsets. And finally, Iron Rebellion. The game is all about the immersive experience of being a mech pilot, with all the buttons, levers, and ammunition you need to dominate the battlefield, and it can be quite a challenging task, but very rewarding at the end. In case you don't know, a free demo of Iron Rebellion is available on Steam right now, so you can go ahead and check it out while we're waiting for the release of the full game, hopefully by the end of this year.
Let me know which games you're most excited about. This month is going to be insanely busy, and I will try to cover as many games as I can on my channel as they get released, so make sure to subscribe to Disco VR so that you don't miss my gameplay reviews and other VR goodness. Thank you so much for watching, friends. Stay safe, and as always, happy gaming!